Hi Pink Filler, this is Shamita Shetty and today I'm going to tell you what I eat in the day. So I'm not one of those blessed souls who can just eat whatever and get away with it because my sister is that way. I tend to put on weight easily, so I make sure that I work out at least a minimum of 4 times in the week. I don't like dieting. If I really want to eat something, I'll go ahead and eat it. Complete chocoholic. But yeah, one new change that I made in my diet, I've given up wheat, I've given up lactose, and I find that it's really made a difference in the way I feel. I think maybe wheat kind of tends to bloat you a little, even milk for that matter. And cutting both of these things from my diet, I think since 5-6 months, has really made a difference. The first thing that I do in the morning is I have 2 glasses of warm water. So something new that I started is apple cider vinegar. That's the first thing I have in the morning, one tablespoon of apple cider vinegar in warm water. It's supposed to be very good for health. My doctor asked me to start with this. It takes care of acidity. I think it's really made a major difference. So, generally when I'm working out, that's the first thing I do in the morning. I don't really like to eat a heavy breakfast. If I'm not working out, then I'll, maybe do my eggs and my gluten-free toast. But otherwise, it's just maybe my gluten-free toast. And then I work out. Post my workout, what I eat at that time is very important because your protein intake has to be good. I weight train, so especially when I do my legs, I make sure that I have enough protein in my food right after, at least half an hour to 45 minutes after your workout. That's when your body really absorbs everything very well. So your meal, your post-workout meal is actually very important. I try my level best to stick to very simple Indian khana, to be honest. It's my sabzi, a little bit of dal, just moong dal or masoor dal. The other ones again tend to bloat you a little. My protein, which is chicken, fish, egg, whatever it is, and my vegetables, and of course either brown rice or quinoa. I eat a lot of rice. And post that, I think I try to keep at least a 3-hour gap between every meal. In the day, I have about 5 to 6 meals. That's about it. So the thing is, not many people know this, but I tend to have 2 dinners. I'm an insomniac and I get extremely hungry because I sleep so late. So I try my level best to keep my second dinner a little light. Maybe just, egg bhurji. No carbs really mixed in at that time. But whatever I eat for lunch is what I eat for dinner. I'm not really a soup and salad kind of person. Like I said, I don't like dieting. I need my khana because I have quite a big appetite, I think, for a woman. My favorite meal of the day, I think I enjoy every meal, to be honest, especially my dessert. And I have quite a bad sweet tooth. I'm quite a chocoholic actually, so maybe that's the one thing I look forward to in the day. So I believe in finishing my workout, first half of the day. That's actually the first thing that I do in the morning, because if you guys are doing cardio, that really increases your metabolism all day long, So it's good to do it on an empty stomach first thing in the morning. When you weight training, of course, eat something small, like light before that. It's always nice to complete your workout, I think, first half of the day. I think mostly men like to work out in the evenings. I don't really know why, but my energy, I'm a little drained of energy, as the day progresses. So I don't like to be tired and, then walk into my gym in the evening. So Also, I think when I work out in the morning, I feel a lot more energetic and happy. So that's why maybe I stick to the morning slot. I don't do that. You know, sometimes maybe when you're shooting and you have, an important song routine or some scene where, you need to highlight your body or your abs, then you take a lot of care of your salt intake at that time, your water intake. But I don't think I've done that in a very long time, to be honest. Yeah, I make sure that maybe one night before I don't binge on chocolates or, any sort of dessert. And also maybe I try and keep the last meal a little lighter because, it just unnecessarily gives you too much water retention and all the next day. So they basically say it's good to cheat once a week, especially if you're following a really strict diet and workout regime. But I don't really follow these rules. I eat when I want to. And if I'm really, really craving something, then I just feel, you live once, Just go ahead and eat it, but make sure that you work out well the next day. Something that I've not had in years now is red meat. I don't know why, I just don't feel like eating red meat, and also I think it really overloads the body. They say it's better to avoid red meat, so I try and stick to white meat. So I work out a minimum of 4 times a week, and I weight train. I don't like to do too much cardio because I tend to lose a lot of weight on my lower body. But weight training is something I really enjoy. My favorite form of exercise would be weight training and kickboxing. I think, strangely, when I'm working, I don't focus that much on food. I automatically don't feel that hungry. I don't know why. My sport boy has to actually tell me, okay, 3 ghante ho gaye, 4 ghante ho gaye. And then I just eat something, and sometimes there's no time to really sit down and eat a meal. Then, I make sure I just maybe eat a few nuts. That kind of gives you energy, or like this ORS drink. That's also good if your BP is, dropping. But as far as staying motivated is concerned, I think I love working, so I don't really need much to motivate me when it comes to work. I'm happy doing what I need to. Alcohol is not healthy. I don't know whoever said alcohol is healthy. It needs a slap. But I think for older people, they say one peg, every night is good for the heart. The doctor used to tell my dad this. But I think maybe single malt is not the healthiest, but maybe best of worst, maybe. No, I'm not one of those who actually counts the number of calories I'm taking in the day and all. I'm not that particular. So, when you're just getting out of school, getting into college, you really want to lose weight fast. And at least at that time, I had no knowledge on, right eating, the right way to work out, and the healthy way of living. I had absolutely no clue. So we used to eat this, or rather follow this Kakdi and Gajar diet and all of that rubbish that really destroyed my health at that time, I think. But at that time I used to really, I think, starve, not really eat what I really wanted to eat because I wanted to lose weight quickly, and I think a lot of kids out there do this. So I would just say, it's one life, just enjoy yourself, eat what you really want to, but just make it a point to, add some sort of physical activity in your day. Make it a point to work out. To detox from binge, I think I just try and cut down my carbohydrate intake for a few days and maybe spend some more time in the gym. I would much rather eat everything I wanted to and work out in the gym. I don't know, I think I have to thank my parents for the skin, but I don't do much for my skin. I just think the more you do, you know, people tend to get obsessed when you start taking too much care of your skin or your weight, and you know what I mean? But I just make it a point to drink a lot of water in the day because it flushes out, you know, all the extra toxins in your body. And it's important to keep yourself hydrated because that really shows in your skin. And of course, a positive and healthy state of being. I mean, just a healthy mind kind of reflects, you know, on your outer personality, I guess. So I hope you liked the tips that I gave you guys, and I hope it helps you in some way. If you like this video, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to Pink Villa. Bye.